Hello, hello, everybody. This is Jack, and welcome back to a brand new live stream. How's it going? So I wanted to ask you guys, for starters, is my sound all right? Is the music too loud? Because the music of the game won't go higher than this, and I want to make sure that you can hear me clearly. So today in this, on the stream we have Ocean Prince, Arturius, Porks and Swine, and Adam Wiley. We also have Sonic and Mega Luca, and of course Juan Schwartz, which will be our guest today. But first, I am going to talk about the t-shirts that are on sale. Don't forget to check those t-shirts out. We have now a new t-shirt with 100% for charity, so if you really want to support the charity, you can go there to the description of this video, this live stream, and find out, get your own t-shirt and help support Child's Play. That's going to be awesome. And you can also have a little blue, you know, design on your t-shirt, which I got one of mine today. It looks awesome. So and it's really good quality, trust me. It's actually a quite hot t-shirt. It's not the light material that you'd think. We also have a Discord chat. So if you want to join in at the end of this stream, we'll be accepting your entries if you want to join in. Unfortunately, during the stream, I won't be able to, but at the end of the stream, you will be able to be part of the Discord chat and chill with us. I wanted to make sure one other little thing before we start. I want to make clear that Patreon is a monthly support. You also have the direct PayPal donations you can do, but Patreon is a monthly support. So make sure you if you want to support the channel in any way, if you go for Patreon, it's a monthly support, okay? And I say that because there are rewards you can get through Patreon if you pledge a certain amount. You have to at least donate twice to be able to get that reward. That is a little change of rules that I put up just to make sure that the Patreons are Patreons and not just the donors, okay? But anyway, I will thank you all so much if you leave a like on this video, and don't forget to subscribe. And we are pretty much about ready to start, but we're missing someone. Hey Juan, welcome to the stream. Ready to go.
I've been ready to go my whole life.
All right, awesome. So I see King Sans, my sister, and that's it. I think that's the only two I saw in the chat popping up. Welcome to the stream. Totally. We're going to start in about 4 minutes. Any words you want to put out there first before we start the stream? Anything you want to say in special?
Not really. Like, pretty much just that, I'm super psyched to be here doing this. I think it's the thing. You know, when you first started having guests on here, like playing games with you and shit, it was like the first thing I thought of was, I don't think Half-Genie Hero was even out yet, but the first thing I thought of was like, oh, we gotta do Shantae when it comes out.
Definitely. I thought about that too.
Totally.
But seeing how hyped you were for that, I think that's the best we did right now. I'm gonna ask the chat real quick. Can you hear Juan properly? Am I louder than him? Is he louder than me? Anything specific you want to fix in the sound quality? You know, to make sure that everything is fine for you guys.
Do I sound? Is my voice buttery and smooth?
Buttery and smooth. Awesome. And now we wait for the chat to catch up with the stream. When it's a bit quieter. Yeah. I will try to... Let me see. Is my sound better now? like more balanced, you know? Because I know Juan is might be a little bit quieter. Is that better now?
Possibly. Tad low. Get low, yeah, get low.
Yeah, I remember that. I remember that from I remember that song from Need for Speed Underground. I used to play the heck out of that game.
But you know, I thought we'd be killing two birds with, or not even two, maybe more birds with one stone. And the fact that, you know, you'd be playing the game for the first time, and that'd be about it with. I think Adam here is the only other person who's played it, and it's really a good to you know, spread the word of the game. And I know there's a lot of people here who have never played a Shantae game ever. So it's cool. This is a really good one to start with, because, you know, Pirate's Curse is a direct sequel to Risky's Revenge, and those two games are so tied together that you kind of have to play them both for the full experience. This one's more standalone. So
this one is kind of a reboot, right? Kind of more of a reboot than the other titles.
Well, it takes place after Pirate's Curse. There's a lot of, you know, they talk about things that have already happened. But story-wise, it is a new story. It doesn't have anything to do with, like, you know, the shit that happened before the Pirate Master and all that stuff. It's all new. So it's all good.
Oh, yeah. All right. Well, let's find out what this story is about, shall we?
Let's do it.
Let's get started with the game. Let's go. All right, here we are. Title screen of the game. Sorry for the little silence here. We're about to start. This is the first time I opened the game. I don't know anything about it. So as far as I know, start new game. Let's get started.
Got it.
What awaits us? Oh, this is Risky. This is Risky. I can clearly see Risky's silhouette here.
Got it.
And this looks like a Shantae. So, cool. We have different modes, but we have to complete the game and maybe unlock them. How does that work?
Yeah, it's, you know, every game's got, I think Pirate's Curse had pirate mode, and there was magic mode in Risky's Revenge. That's the same thing. It's called hero mode. So it's...
Oh, okay, yeah. I see. So this is hero mode, right?
The other Shantae one is hero mode.
And this is the DLC, right? I heard that maybe there will be a DLC for that game. Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
I'm gonna play the DLC, guys. I'm gonna play the DLC. Trust me.
Yeah. I hope so.
There you go. Let's get started right away. New game. Are you ready? Hype!
Let's get ready to Shantae!
Rumble! Hashtag chance.
Let's get ready to go!
I hear some noises. Huh? Is someone there?
Oh, she's so cute. She's cute.
Hello? I love those pajamas. Okay, so, yeah. Jumping with A. All right. Nothing special. Oh, yeah. It looks like the notifications
her hair
are on.
Down right now, so you can't really do anything.
Oh, wait. That's the sound from the Game Boy game.
Yeah.
The crawling sound.
Totally.
That's awesome. That's a nice reference. Well, I'm not going to do anything else but follow the path, because I don't think we have to do anything here, right?
No, not
it's
at
nighttime.
All. There's nothing going on in her house except a sleepy genie.
All right.
She does her little butt wiggle too when you crouch down, of course.
Let's do the butt wiggle. Oh, yeah. Wait a second. I'm going to increase the volume of the game. It sounds a little bit too quiet.
For sure.
Okay, maybe that's better. Let's go. Let's get going. Okay. So far, so good.
Hello? Visually, this is just really impressive.
Hello, Leonard. Welcome to the stream.
Leonard! Hello. Hello, hello.
You fell asleep in your workshop again, huh? Ah. I've seen that trapdoor there before. I wonder where it leads. I haven't seen that trapdoor. Okay, that sounds suspicious. Just jump right in. I suppose you have to push boxes? No, you don't need to.
No, you can just go.
Alright. Let's go. Do I need a torch or something? No. Can't do anything.
You just
Let's go.
Need to walk around.
Let's keep moving. Oh, I see. Okay. So the fire kills those enemies. That's cool.
Yeah.
Alright, let's take advantage of that. We can't get hurt by the fire, which is good. Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Nice. Analyzing everything here right now. Come on. Come on, you pesky bats. Oh, ah. Alright, take that. Was quite easy. So basically this is introduction, but after that I think Shantae gets everything to attack, like full powers, right?
Yeah, you get more ways of attack. You know, you're not fully powered in the beginning, but you know, right now her glorious monster whipper is down. Her hair's down, so you can't do much. Once she
Okay, you can whip, which makes sense.
Yeah.
By the way, Leonard, the guest commentator is Juan Schwartz, which has been part of the streams since a few months ago. I don't remember exactly when you joined, started watching the streams actually, but it was like three, 4 or maybe more months ago. It was quite a while ago.
Yeah.
You joined then in the wave of 2016, which was a great year for the channel. So I thank you everyone for joining in, and supporting the channel so far. Let me try to read at the same time I speak, which is impossible.
Yeah,
okay.
It was right after Color Splash. I think I caught the last Color Splash.
Oh, okay. So I see. Yeah, I see when it was. Yeah, more or less that period. That's cool. That's cool, man. Who are you? Ah, a messenger from the genie realm. Gasp. Great danger. Okay. So this is warning me about danger. Chance of darkness will strike. Okay, I see. Don't mind the notifications of Steam. I just let them in because I wanted to I wanted to make sure that you saw the achievements rolling, because that's something that I really like about Steam. So I wanted to show you the achievement system and what you can get from the game.
There's a little bit, you know. I don't even know about that stuff because I played it on Wii, so I'm not even sure what the achievements are.
Mm-hmm.
Knowing way forward, they're probably.
I don't know if my voice might be delayed actually, so I'm sorry about that. If my voice my commentary seems like delayed compared to Juan's, I'm sorry about that. Okay, it's because my software delays my voice for some reason. Helps make my voice clearer.
I thought the delayed one.
Oh, really? Well, I don't know. Maybe they end up matching. Oh, what about my mother? Is she there with you? Can barely hear you. Is she in danger too? Please tell me. ... Please, I have to know. Don't leave me. So yeah. In case you don't know, Shantae is an orphan.
Yeah,
she has to take care of herself.
Mother's a genie. Father is some guy.
Some guy.
Her mom was actually thought to be deceased, but then we eventually find out that she's alive, but she's in the genie realm. And that's currently where we are with that. It's sort of an overarching plot to Shantae is what to deal with her mom.
All right, I see. Well, that was all a dream. So it was kind of a premonition dream, like, we'll see. And one of the best tracks. There you go, Red to Go. The game's just started. It's that's the save guy. Hello. Saving, thank you. So, yeah. What now? Let's see. Let's explore a little bit. Typical Shantae movements. Workshop. All right, let's see the workshop. Hello, Uncle Mimic.
It's a lot prettier, but it's the same old controls, which is a good thing.
Oh yeah, definitely. It's definitely a good thing. I'm used to them. I tried to speedrun Pirate's Curse, but I didn't end up finishing the speedrun, and I didn't record any of it. So
shit.
I'm kind of used to the controls at this point.
I did a great speedrun of this game a few days ago, week ago. Yeah.
Okay. Are you going to record someday and share it to the public? Hint, hint. Nudge, like wink, stuff.
Yeah. I think that's very likely. You know, I've thrown out the idea to you before about doing not even just a speedrun, but a whole channel dedicated to Shantae's or the whole series. So it's
which I think is a good thing. I mean, it's a growing series, and people are getting more and more into it. And it's nice to have a reference point about the Shantae series. And since you're a huge fan of the series, I think it's the best thing you should do. I'll watch it.
Totally, man. It's the only
Hello, Sky.
Only series that I feel like this sort of passionately about. It's an important series to me for sure.
All right, so apparently we have to look for Bolo for something, right?
Yeah.
For Mimic, by the way, just to Yeah. So here's Bolo. Bolo.
Yeah. He's pervin.
Bolo is one of the best characters of the game. Kinda. This woman, she's
distracted.
Like, a bathroom angel. Oh, good gravy. Not this again. Snap out of it. Can't look away. Never mind. I'll talk to her. Okay, hello. Good morning, and welcome to the bathhouse. This is what? Basically a tutorial thing, or is it story-wise? I think it's just to explain to you how the bathhouse works, right?
Yeah, pretty much. There's not a lot you do in it. Later on, it's basically like the hint place. It's like, remember the hint guy from Earthbound? It's basically that. We'll tell you, like, not like full out tell you where to go, but she'll give you like some cryptic
hints.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I see. Typically. Yeah. That's good. Sales slip. All right, cool. Water. So now we have the receipt. I guess we have to. Yeah, deliver it to the shop. Yep, alright, that's cool. Yeah, the receipt. Yeah, please. So basically this game is a lot of trading. That's a staple for the series. There's a lot of trading going on for different items and quests to do. But it's essentially a platformer. An action platformer with a Metroidvania aspect, you know? So you have to explore and then sometimes come back to some levels and find out what you have to do.
Totally.
Well, at least that's what the series is known for.
Oh, yeah. You know, it's always had its fair share of backtracking.
Cool.
It was stuck to this box.
You got the magnet. Yeah, I noticed that joke, actually. That's the best place to store a magnet in a box of hard drives. Goodness.
The Shantae games are also known for being incredibly funny,
there's also a lot of little jokes like that, which I think it makes the game even more charming than it is.
Oh, totally. They're just super irreverent and witty and all kinds of other adjectives. So
that means it's time to show off my latest invention. All right, cool.
Here it is.
That's awesome. It's kind of unsettling.
Oh yeah.
Mimic. Well, last time you created something, it went to crap.
Yeah, trust me, it gets a lot more unsettling later on.
I can kind of smell risky from here. I don't know why.
Yeah.
Oh my! Well, what is it, Uncle? Okay, something that will help you defend the town. Okay, cool. I call it the Dynamo. Wait, have I heard that name before? Okay, cool. Dino Meow? Dynamo. Okay. Uh-huh. Contraption from the old world. Oh, yeah. Okay, yeah, yeah. Mimic has the that idea of exploration. He is also a treasure hunter, kind of. And he was mostly interested in the old people that inhabited this place with technologies and stuff. And you know, other games he created machines based on those plans from those old artifacts. So this is one of those machines, the Dynamo. Mm-hmm. Okay.
First game was the steam engine, and this is.
Yeah, the steam engine. There you go, from the first game.
All
right, here we go.
The plot of Shantae is it basically hints that the series takes place in the far future after like the fall of humanity as we know it, which is
kind
of
right.
But it's hinted at pretty strongly, which is kind of funny.
I'm not surprised actually. I'm not surprised that's a thing.
Yeah.
Although it might also be kind of like in a midpoint between the two, you know. Because nowadays we have like the Legend of genies in lamps, which in Shantae they strongly make it that genies were free people. And they were trapped inside lamps, right? I think that's the plot of Shantae. So it could also be a midpoint, like there were all those inventions back in the day, then Shantae came around, and then we have nowadays.
Could be.
You know, there's different hypotheses here. So it's an interesting story, nonetheless.
Yeah, I think it was kept purposely. Purposely vague, and that's cool. It's open to interpretation.
I think so, definitely. We won't fight over it, that's for sure.
No.
Dynamo blueprints. Okay. I had them last night, but no, they're gone.
Sure hope these blueprints
in the basement?
Don't get stolen.
Oh my goodness, I sure hope not. Like there's no pirates around. Did you try looking in the basement? Hint, hint. What basement? I knew it. My workshop hasn't got one. But there's a trap door right in the. Oh, bye. Ah, okay. A Tinker Bat. You should have woken up like 5 minutes ago. He just ran off. Don't worry, Uncle. Oh crap! It's burning town all over again.
Yeah.
Cannon
Town's fire!
Oh boy. Okay, I've got to go. It's good old times. Exactly. Thank you, Shantae. All right, Sky's Hatchery.
I wonder how much money. Like that's why Skulltown is always so. Is like because all the town's money is sunk into repairing it because it's constantly getting destroyed by pirates. Or
definitely.
Or ammo in the third game.
Ammo Baron and
something else. Yeah. Like no matter what, like whatever the threat is, it will fuck up Scuttletown. Shantae
definitely.
Is usually blamed for it. Or not blamed, but she gets in trouble somehow over it. usually gets fired by the mayor.
Mega Wrench Metamorphosis! Oh my goodness. Wow! Wrench, you grew so big! How did he... Here. Oh, I got a whistle. Blow my whistle, baby.
If you get the good ending, like the true mm-hmm. ending, she will explain to you how Wrench got so big.
Oh, I can't wait for that. We need to actually get that explanation. That will be our objective. It's 100%, you say? All right.
No, you don't need to get 100% to get the good ending. But there is like...
Okay.
Where you basically have like an option of what to do. And like, there's a certain way that you should go. Like, there's a certain item that if you don't have it, like, you're not going to get the good ending. So that's all I'll say right now.
Okay. Well, I see the map screen here. That's a nice little animation, but it doesn't really fit the mood. Let's go. Save Scuttletown. Go to Main Street.
Yeah.
All right. Here we go. Save the game. Save complete. Oh, boy. This is your stop. Now, about that bird whistle. I've added it to your subscreen. What's a subscreen? Fourth wall. Breaking.
Yeah.
There you go, the whistle.
The series is famous for its lack of...
Yeah, I was kind of expecting that for some reason. I don't know why. All of the items you collect can be found there. Well, yeah, because... Yeah, there you go. Subscreen and blow that whistle. And blow that whistle, baby. Split ends of justice. My silky split ends of justice. That's the best quote. Just go. I won't let you down. I won't let you down either. No, I mean, I'm literally not letting you down. Get...
He pushes her.
Ouch. What's her deal? All right. Ready to go? I'm ready. Let's go.
That's it.
Oh, yeah. That's a team song. Okay, we start off really well. Can I destroy this? Yes, I can. Yeah, okay, cool. I was too close to it.
Yeah, when those things come down, make sure to be away from them. Not only because they'll hit you, but three guys jump out every time.
Okay.
I love the
usage I see that.
Of the song here. It's, the usage of the song here was awesome. It kind
definitely.
Of, that feeling of like... You know, opening credits or something. You know, the beginning of the journey, and it's really it makes
definitely.
It really hype, for sure. It really, really works out well, and it's a great song. We've had this song for the 3 years, and it was like, other than a few screenshots, it was like the only
ouch
thing that we had about Half-Genie here, and it's awesome. They try to use it as many times as they could in this game, and for good reason.
Oh boy, I was expecting a heart or something. Why am I always already dying? It's like... Oh, there you go. Thank you.
Exactly.
I have to get used to the controls again.
They are the cannonballs for sure. There's a lot of things that carry over from all the games.
I think you can quite clearly see that I'm more used to play like the first Shantae game because I tend to try to hit the enemies crouched. Which is something you kind of have to do in the first Shantae, but in this one your hair kind of reaches them. They're a little bit taller. Ouch.
Yeah, they are. You've got some really good range on. Sometimes mm-hmm. you don't think that you'll be able to hit them, and it turns out you can. It's pretty. The hair is. Nice. You know, every Shantae game gives you all these late game abilities and weapons and shit, magic spells like. The thunder and the fire and all that shit, and like no matter what, like the hair is still your thing. Like you rely on that no matter what.
Kaboom.
Yeah. Dun, 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 dun. Must be pretty fun.
I love this scene.
Top. It's cool.
Oh yeah. I don't know about the landing, but yeah. I don't know about the landing, but yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Definitely.
Get shot out of a cannon with a couple of my buddies inside a ball.
Yeah.
We're gonna go fight fucking G.
Oh goodness.
Totally. Good old Scuttletown.
It has getting as nice much stuff as I can.
Going. Yeah, definitely do that. Get money, man. Money, money, money. To get
money, 100%. Money, money.
Yeah.
Money.
I tend to press B on my controller to select the options, but you actually have to press the jump button to select the options, which is kind of weird because you have to interact with B.
Shit.
Okay, I remember that puzzle. I'm getting Shantae GBC vibes for some reason. Oh, come on. Good. I love this song, by the way. Oh, the timing is off in my head.
You know, when I first played this, I had the same issue. It was really weird. But
yeah, you think it'd be faster, right?
Yeah, totally. Eventually, it just becomes second.
I took a crap right now.
It's okay. You can't really talk to her, the chef girl. It's the same chef girl from Risky's Revenge. And I think
that's what I was kind of trying to figure out. She looks like that. She looks like her, at least.
Yeah.
So, if you confirm that, that's... Girl. There you go. We killed her dog, actually. I remember that.
Her dog is still dead.
Canonically, it's canon that Shantae killed her dog. And got the rupees, the gems for it.
So right now, like, you don't really have any transformations or anything, so you can't really get too many hidden things. But I'll tell you one thing you can do right now. Like down here at the bottom, when you get to the bottom,
if you look here, there's an indentation, but it's obvious that Shantae cannot fit through that, so that I didn't do anything about it.
When you come back after you beat the level, you get the monkey, and there's a heart container inside there. But down here at the bottom, to the right, you'll see these three big windows.
Yep.
To the right.
I'm here. I'm here.
These three big windows, there's Tinkerbath jumping out of them. If you kill 30 of them, you'll get the health permit, which is what the chef is going to ask you for later on. So if you want to do that right now.
I can kind of do that right away, right?
Yeah, so
or do I have to trigger the mission?
You don't have to trigger the mission, you just do it right now.
Okay. Cuz usually you have to talk to the character before you do that. So kind of stuff. But it's cool. It's cool.
I'll
do that right away.
If you talk to her, it'll actually, like, a counter will actually come up that says how many pirates you've defeated. But even if you don't, you can still do it. And once it hits 30, you did it. It'll spit out the piece of paper.
There you go. Health permit. All right, cool. Thank you for that hint. So you know now you can do it right away. Thank you, Juan, for the hint. For those who play the game, now you know.
Indeed. You'll be coming back here pretty soon. So.
All right.
You can come back here a lot, actually. There's Main Street especially has got a lot of stuff that it kind of goes till way late in the game as far as reasons to come back here. But that's
as you can see, it's kind of a habit. I do crouch before attacking. Always. It's kind of like it's obligatory for me. I really.
That's okay.
Hope it doesn't come back to bite me. Okay, flower. That's pretty. Pretty flowers. Ah. That's hot. Hot. This game is really cute and beautiful.
Oh, yeah. It's just visually. This is what Mighty No. 9, like, should have looked like, you know?
Mm-hmm. Definitely. Okay, boss time? Hello? Oh, wow, I know who you are. Hello, Risky. Risky Boots. Exactly, Risky Boots.
Yeah. That boat hauls ass, dude.
Tut-tut. Call me Queen of the Seven Seas, if you please. Back to your old tricks, I see. You don't sound happy to see me. No matter. Hey, what I came for. Looking for this? Oh, yes, I want that, actually.
Yeah,
Uncle's blueprint. Give that back. Mm-hmm. Your dim-witted relic hunting uncle is always unearthing valuables from the Lost Age. The Lost Age, that's what we were talking about earlier.
Yeah.
And whatever secrets this blueprint contains, I want them. Mm-hmm. Claim my rightful place as the ruler of Sequinland. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Step aside.
Yeah,
okay, let me just read that part, because I know that part. Step aside or suffer the might of my part omni-organic, partially titanic, ocean-optional tanker slug. That's quite the name, right? Poop toot? For short?
Poop toot.
That's
fucking
awesome.
Poop toot.
Don't call him that.
Yeah, she
Man.
Gets all
pissed. Lock
so, yeah,
and load.
For anyone thinking like that after Pirate's Curse is like, oh, is Risky gonna be good now? Like, no, not at all. She's worse in this game than she's ever been. Like, she's straight up pretty evil in this one.
Okay, I can't attack the dude.
Hit that fucking bell. Just keep hitting the bell.
Oh. Okay, hi. I saw that. I figured. Attack!
Yeah. Hit the bell and then a barrel will appear like that. And then, you know.
There you go. Ow, I got hit, actually. That fire in the background is kind of throwing me off for some reason. It's like I'm always expecting to hit that fire and get hurt, but it's my problem. It's like I'm playing with a really small screen. I should kind of increase the size of my screen, actually. It's actually really easy.
Oh yeah, totally. Once you get the
come on, poop toot.
Just hit that fucking bell. I mean that's.
That's, I always forgot
about
that.
The name of the game fighting this guy.
I see. I can see that. The bell is everything we need. Yep. Poop Toot has been defeated.
Yeah. Excuse me.
Bless ya.
Oh,
that was Poop Toot's
me.
Explosion sound, by the way.
Yeah. Poor Poop Toot. He didn't ask for any of this, you know?
Surrender the blueprints, Risky Boots. That's not the right face to have, Shantae. You shouldn't be so ashamed.
Yeah, she seems just a little agitated about it.
Yeah. Only postponing the inevitable victory. Oh boy. We got the dynamo. Another time runt. You lubbers.
I actually beat her right away for once.
It's awesome.
Or did you?
And don't come back. Did I? Well, isn't that over?
I guess she's just not gonna come back.
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, I defeated Poop Toot. There's no chance of her coming back, right?
Shantae, not at all.
Shantae, you're too nice. You should have, like, whipped her face right away.
She
oh,
is
hi.
Too nice. Shantae is a brilliant hero, but at the same time, she's got a bit of ditziness to her. It's
mm-hmm.
It's endearing.
Yeah.
It's endearing. It's all part of her charm, though. She's a wonderful character, for sure.
Oh, okay, that's new. Take transformation. Okay.
Yeah.
So
all of your key transformations you're gonna get at the end of chapters like this. So,
monkey! We got the monkey, the cutest thing ever. Press Y
cool
to dance.
Book.
I'm gonna press Y to dance. Awesome.
There you go.
Oh, okay, I get it. Okay, cool. Then I de-transform. Without selecting anything, I can go back. Okay. Oh, that's cool. That's really easy to use now.
Yeah, it's just a little wheel.
It's awesome.
They've really simplified it this time. You know, as much as I loved the rhythm, you know, sort of game of the first one when it came to transforming, a lot of people didn't. Like, they thought it really slowed down the gameplay and stuff.
And I think the biggest problem with that dancing mechanic was the game didn't pause. So basically, yeah, if you started dancing, true, the enemies could hit you. And you're totally out of control in that situation. Like, you can't do anything about it.
You gotta dance,
which was kind of bad. That's probably why they changed it. Because right now it seems like it kind of pauses the game, right? Around you.
Oh, it does.
I'll have to test that out with enemies.
It does.
Yeah, yeah. So it's better. Yeah.
Revenge did the, you know, you hold the button and then wait for her to do the move that you want and stuff. That was fine, but I think this game really nails it as far as being able to do the dance transformations like on the fly. You can do like three or four just rapid fire, like if you're later in the game when you're pretty used to doing them all the time.
Yeah. But now, I mean, what happened? I mean, I'm fired again?
I'm fired again.
I love that.
She's been
fired again?
Like, she gets fired in every game.
Yeah. I remember when you have to, like, convince the mayor back in, I think, Risky's Revenge, right? And he's, like, in his chore, and he's chilling, and you have to, like, convince him to put Shantae back to the spot. It's like, oh my goodness.
Sure.
Yeah, Main Street is a shamble of is in shambles, and pirates are running pell-mell all over town. Okay.
Yeah, he's a pretty stupid dumbass. It's become a tradition that Shantae gets fired in every game now.
A new guardian genie. Wait.
What?
No way. Lots of half-genie guardian towns these days. just send your curriculum, you're fine. We need a new half-genie. They're everywhere.
He was
not unique. Hello, Avery. Welcome to the stream. I might have missed some people, actually. I was focused in the game. How are you guys in the chat? Are you enjoying the game so far? There's a lot of cool little details in this game. You should read if I don't read it for you.
Yeah, totally. It's a spectacular game.
Free rent, amazing ocean view, negligible fish smell. Apply today. Perfect sign. Okay, I never got free rent. ignore him. Yeah. He'll come around once this dynamo is complete. If you say so, Uncle. Well, I don't know, because if it's supposed to protect the town, well, right, it's supposed to make a shield of some sort, right? Or at least.
Just, it generates electricity. It's
which allows anything to, like, help Shantae, which at the same time, it also makes for Shantae being useless.
That's true. That's
poor
true.
Girl.
It's really, I think, something he really thought about. You know, the Uncle Mimic can get tunnel vision, which is really, really
yeah,
into it.
Yeah, quite.
So he's a nice guy, but, you know, him and Shantae make quite the pair.
Yeah, definitely.
They're both a little airheaded sometimes. It's adorable.
I'm ready to go, if anyone needs me. So basically what I gathered from this is that you kind of have to roam around town and talk to people?
Well, it'll become pretty obvious pretty shortly you'll need to go next. But I would suggest, now that you've got the monkey, to go back to Main Street and get a few things.
I usually do this at this time. I go and get some sort of items.
Yeah, you've got a little bit of money, some items would be nice. I would recommend the the hair cream and the shampoo.
A silky cream.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was thinking about that because the sooner you have fast hair whip and stronger hair whip, the better it is. So I'm gonna go for silky smooth hair and shampoo.
You wouldn't think it, like, it makes a difference, but it does.
It does. Like, it does.
You want to whip fast.
Yeah, I kind of feel the difference already. Like, it's really subtle, but it's there.
Yeah.
No,
totally.
It's not that subtle. No, it's actually like almost double speed. That's quite awesome. Yeah, that's
there
great.
It means that it's like the difference between living or dying. You know.
Yeah. Hey, Bri the Gamer, welcome to the stream.
Indeed. What's up?
What's up? It's Juan, the co-commentator for today.
Got it.
If you remember him from the streams. He participated in he's one of the moderators of the streams, actually. So say hi. Ready to lift off?
Word?
Actually yes, I'm quite ready to lift off because I'm gonna try to go there again to Burning Town.
I would suggest it first. There's a few things that, not really in the first part, but in the second part, there are a few things. There's that little hole in the wall that you noticed, and then...
Oh, yeah, that's right. You're right. I forgot about that one.
There's also, you can get the monkey bullet, too, right now, which you don't want. But yeah, of course I was going to be here. You know, I'm the world's biggest Shantae
fan.
I had to be here. She's doing Half-Genie Hero.
I can do this without a box.
Super nice to be here.
I sure hope you're enjoying your time here. And since this is going to be the Shantae series and... you will be part of all the streams from now on, if you can.
Totally, man. Absolutely. I hope so. You know, the game is awesome all the way through. I mean, there's...
Oh, yeah.
There's just... There's no, like bad part of it, you know? It's like some games, there'll be, like, a lull or, a part that no one really likes. And this game doesn't really have that, which is cool. You know, it's sort of... Sort of comprised four or five little stories, like in and of themselves. They're like chapters, but like without actually being labeled as chapters.
Mm-hmm. I see.
And they're all super creative. The next one you do is the mermaid thing, which I won't talk about right now. But it was
in the demo, right? That's the level from the demo, the mermaid falls.
Okay, then yeah, totally. But as far as like what the whole deal with that is, it's pretty funny, pretty creative.
I don't know what the starfish did. It did something though.
Funny thing about the starfish, if you once you have the mermaid transformation. Like, the starfish will not attack you, and if you jump in the water and they follow you, the starfish, they will,
if you jump
in the water with her, if you have the mermaid transformation, they won't attack you. Jump in the water, they will fall in love with her and follow her around, and they will help you defeat enemies.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, it's cool.
Cool.
It's super. There's a great, I won't spoil it, but there's a part near the end of the game where you see that happen in full force, and it's really cool.
That's awesome. I honestly can't wait to visit, well, pretty much all the levels. I mean, I was actually really hyped to play the game, actually, since I heard about it. Awesome. I've played all the titles of Shantae, and I finished them all, but boy oh boy.
So, we've been waiting a long time for this game, I swear. It's 3 years. I mean, it doesn't seem that long, but imagine you were in 2013, you know?
Yeah.
All we had was Dance Through the Danger and...
and a few screenshots and ideas.
Shots, yeah.
Nothing much. Here's the health pyramid.
Boom. Why is
the town should be not burning at this point. What are you waiting for?
Salted caramel. The foreseeable future.
Oh, yeah. I call it Caramella Poopa. In honor of my dog, Wobble Bell.
Who is dead now?
Oops. Don't tell her. Excuse me.
I think she knows. That's why she named it that. It's like, you know, to honor him and his, his deceased form.
His deceased form.
The Village of Lost Souls in the third one. It's like...
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I think I remember that.
Yeah.
Oh, my god.
Pretty funny.
Wait a second. I know there's stuff down there, but... Cool.
Go over that wall.
Hello! Tinker Bats. I take a lot of damage in Shantae. I kind of do it on purpose.
That's cool.
Oh, there you go. Monkey Bullet.
Yeah, you get the Found Monkey it. Bullet.
Awesome. How delayed is the chat? Is the stream compared to the chat? Actually, I try to apply as little as possible. No, not this way. I don't feel like it's this way. There might be a lot of delay actually, but I try to put as little as possible. But I can't control that, sadly. Heart container holder. Okay, cool. Heart containers are for Link. Shantae has heart holders.
Yeah, I heard Matt Bowes on. He said that in an interview, but it was really sort of said with a chuckle and a wink. You know what I mean?
Wink, wink, I nudge, nudge.
Definitely implied that the dog is dead. But you know, it's
really... the funnier outcome, to be honest.
And it's the funnier outcome. It's when if you choose to believe he's alive, it's he can be, but
boy,
it's really
I messed up. One question: is there
really
anything else I should do in this level?
Not really. That's okay. Right now. That's pretty much all you can do. There's
can
a
I
bunch
defeat
of other
Poop
stuff.
Toot again?
No, you can't.
No,
Poop
boy.
Toot. He's pooped his last toot.
Nice. Nice one. Okay, I don't think I have to jump all that. Thank you.
No,
that'd be a pain in the butt.
You got the monkey now. Monkey.
The monkey. Shantae the monkey.
Monkey. Oh. Monkey. Half full monkey hero.
Full monkey hero, definitely. With bullet mode. Oh, come on. Stop getting hit. Dang fire. Monkey.
Yeah, these guys are fuckers, man.
There you go. End of the level. I could have quit the level with the whistle, right?
You could have, yeah. I was gonna tell you that, but...
Forget it. It's fun.
I just like watching the game, so it's...
Yeah, at least now we know that what happens when you reach the boss part, you get basically what you see at the end of the boss. So just,
Yeah.
There you go.
I wish that there was sort of like boss rush, but...
there's no boss rush? Oh, that's
a
shame.
There's no way to refight bosses, which is kind of a bummer. Because there's definitely some cool ones. Poop Toot's alright, but like there's... the next boss is super cool, and there's a couple other ones that are just some spectacular showdowns. So.
Let me ask you a question. Doesn't this chick actually look like a character from Mighty Switch Force?
That one.
Look like she's not the same. I know the characters from Mighty Switch Force are different, but isn't she really reminiscent from that?
Like from that series? Like, be in it.
Yeah.
I want to say yeah, but the truth is a lot of Way Forward's characters could probably fit in each other's series. They all have very similar visual style.
It's a similar visual style. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, seeing Mighty Switch Force in there is definitely not surprising.
Yeah, she looks like an NPC from it, right? From the game. Yeah, yeah. Avery kind of sees that too. It's because of the style, like you said, the art style, the character design. Okay,
totally. I heard
that Guardian Genie lived in this town. It must be her. Maybe not. I'm actually fired, so I can't help you. Bye.
That's true.
Count on it. Okay. Oh, thank you, thank you. There's a map of Mermaid Falls. Okay, cool. We can go to Mermaid Falls now. Yeah, fly there quickly. Okay. Let's visit Mermaid Falls, shall we?
Sounds like a plan.
Dude, I just love the soundtrack of this game.
I just love it. Jake Kaufman, man.
A lot of people don't like the style, you know, the hero type style, you know. Let me grab the bubble. I know it was useful at some point.
This game is crazy.
I'm going to get the fireball and the pike ball for now.
Good idea, for sure.
Attract seems interesting. Backdash could be good. Metronome.
Backdash, I never really use that at all. I would, you know, for this point in the game, I would steer away from your offensive stuff, and I would worry more about that. Metronome. You know, the bikini armor is a good thing to have.
Yeah, I can't afford the bikini armor. Hello, Odd Wright. Well, I can't say hi then. No headphones. I can't say hi. I cannot say hi to you. Well,
oh, shit.
Message has been sent. Yeah, yeah. Tell him I say hi. And welcome.
Jack says you suck.
Something like that. No, he's a cool dude, actually. All right, has been really cool. He actually talks to me a lot on Tumblr.
Which is
a page you should check out. My blog there, and I post all my fan art you guys sent, which is awesome. I'm going to get Attract without questions. That's it. I'm going to get Attract. That's it.
Attract comes in handy for sure.
Yeah, I know for a fact that it comes in handy. And that's cool. That's cool. All right.
That pretty much explains itself. You know, it's like money comes to you. I mean,
oh, definitely.
I wish that was like real.
Let's see. Let's test it. Let's see if Oh, there's no more pots. Okay, to test. No problem. We'll get more. Just to see how much range the attract has. Let's save. Saving, and it's saved. Cool. Awesome. So, next step, Sky's Archery.
Yeah.
Mermaid Falls. Are you going there? Yes, looks that way. Well, be careful. Mermaid around those parts are very dangerous, especially the salty water variety. The salt water variety. So, yeah.
Hint, hint, nudge, nudge, you know? I'm glad that Sky has a bigger role in this game. She didn't really do anything in Pirate's Curse.
She didn't. She didn't do much in other games.
She had a little plot with Barracuda Joe, but that was
about it. Yeah. Introduce you to someone. Oh, who is that? Hello. Who are you?
This bitch.
You don't know?
How sad.
Jesus. I'm your replacement, of course. You go back home. What?
Yeah.
I love that.
This fucking trifling bitch.
Holy Lingerbean.
What a fucking scumbag.
Half-Genie Hero for hire. Uh-huh. You couldn't call me Holly.
Whatever. The fuck out of here.
A holy bunch of garbage. Your mom was a genie? That's right. My dad was a stage magician. Perfect couple. I'm more magical than other. Oh, yeah, goodness.
The fuck kind of name is that? What's up with them shorts? Bitch look like she wearing a diaper.
Babies don't work that way. That's true. She stole my nose and removed her own thumb while I watched. You don't have a nose. Wait, stupid. You don't have a nose. Maybe that's why. Okay. Okay. Old Gordon Genie. Me? Ah,
I don't
really?
Know if that would be as nice. That sounds a little too intelligent to be the mayor.
Yeah, a little bit. No big whoop, mayor. I'm sure I'll just be fine without her.
Go fuck yourself.
I can't believe he actually did it. Now, hold on. He replaced me with that snotty little beep. Not now.
Whatever.
Now, calm down. Dude. Yeah.
Nobody gives a fuck about Holly Lee.
You're on a mission, remember? Mm-hmm. I guess you're right. Okay then, off to Mermaid Falls. Are you ready to lift off? Of course I am, since the beginning of the game. Lift off, ready to go. Hype, hype,
boom.
Hype. I was so, well, anxious to play that game. I really wanted to get it and play it. So, I haven't said that on stream, but once again for you, Juan, thank you so much for actually getting the game for us to play today. So, you're the man behind this stream being possible today. So, a big thank you from the chat for Juan. Please, you deserve it.
I wanted it to happen.
You wanted it to happen.
Yeah.
And I wanted it to.
I willed it into existence. Again, when you started having, guests and stuff, it was like, oh shit, we gotta. You know, there's a new Shantae coming up. We gotta do Shantae. It was just.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. It had to be done. I mean, like I said before, I also really enjoy playing Shantae, and I play all the titles before, so I couldn't skip that one.
And
once I saw the updated graphics and all that, to me, it clicked on me. Like, I really have to play that game now.
Totally. It would be, even out of all of them, it would be a shame to miss this one. It's just a beautiful game, and it really takes a lot of. It's like the sum of its parts, you know. It's like after making these games for almost 15 years, it's sort of everything they've learned about Shantae. It uses a lot of ideas and kind of puts them all into this one thing. And the game itself is very much a love letter to the series.
Definitely, but not a love letter to Shantae, apparently. He insisted that I lend you a hand until he could create a machine to replace you. Ugh, fine.
Damn it, Bolo.
Okay.
Damn it.
hey, Bolo, you're awesome, man. You're awesome. Just go fuck yourself.
You gotta love Bolo.
Bolo is awesome. But since the beginning, like, he's awesome.
Oh, totally, man. He's great. I've loved him ever since he was dicking around outside Dribble Fountain back in the day.
Yeah, definitely. Dribbling around.
Yeah.
He became Risky Dribble Fountain, looking at the babes.
Yeah. So Risky punched him in the face and like... like never washed after that.
Yeah, I remember that.
Several years ago.
And you're probably going to get those references too, because I'm probably going, if you haven't played those games, I'm going to play them on the channel at some point, so stay tuned for that too. If not in stream format, I'll probably do a Let's Play, so you can follow along episodic videos of the Shantae series, maybe in the future, so stay tuned for that.
Indeed.
fish folks. Shh. I read that mermaid are beautiful, but often vain. Yes, of course. But you have to be careful. Do you have bubble? Because I remember bubble being really useful against mermaids.
You know, right now, it's not really necessary. But I'll tell you what is necessary, and that was upgrading the speed of your hair, and you already did that, so that's...
I didn't have enough money to do both things. So I should, now when I get the money, do that upgrade first. That's what I'm going to go for. Honestly.
You know, it's rule of thumb as far as upgrades go is your hair is priority number one. Always, always, always upgrade the hair.
It's your main way of attacking, so it only makes sense. If you forget about the you know, hair speed and strength, you won't get around through the game. And that was a thing with the other games too, with the past games. If you forget about upgrading the hair, attack and speed, you won't be able to survive for, or at least attack as strongly as you'd wish you would.
Yeah, totally.
Come on, Bolo, do your job.
Game, you start to come face back. Some stronger opponents, and if your hair isn't up to snuff, you know, could get gruesome.
Yeah, quite quickly, actually. You can get cornered really easily.
Yeah.
And mostly at the beginning of the game, where you don't have as much health.
Yeah.
It goes really quickly. I was about to die in the first level, so as you can see, it's no laughing matter. Ouch. Indeed. Okay, projectiles, so yeah, bubble is useful here. Bubble still works the same way, right?
Water. What's that?
There you go. No, I was asking if a bubble worked the same way. Okay, I see.
Yeah, it does.
Because it's useful against those projectiles. Yeah, there you go, see? No damage.
As soon as they jump out of the water, you know, start hitting them with the hair, like as soon as they land from jump.
Oh, hi. Avoided taking damage again. I'm a pro.
You should be able to kill him without even using the bubble if you just hit him right away.
Yeah. There you go. Like that.
Yeah. Indeed. You know what they're replaced with after this, right?
What? They're replaced with what?
The mermaids get replaced by a new villain after you can chat a new villain. A new, like, mook, you know? A new enemy after you complete this chapter.
They do?
And it's our old buddies, the Nagas.
Oh, no. Really?
Yeah.
Oh, crap.
They come back.
I hate the Nagas.
But there's a twist to them now. You know what? They're not as bad as they were in the first Shantae.
Oh, I see.
Thank fucking Christ, because anyone who played the first Shantae knows about the horrors of Naga Wasteland Night. My God.
Mm-hmm.
That's harder than anything in this game. That's not necessarily a good thing either.
Yeah.
Fucking Naga. They have homing projectiles. It was like...
Yeah, totally. It's like... There,
like, from the beginning of the game with, like, no health and nothing, like, nothing at all. And you could go there and, like, just get annihilated. I think that's what people talk about when they say the first Shantae is
it allows you to reach first really hard sections of the game, and even then when you're upgraded at some point, it's really hard to keep your health in that game.
They're bastards no matter what.
I think most of the problem and all the games, like all the games in general for the Game Boy suffered from that, is the small screen. I think you had limited vision, and some games didn't work as well because of that.
Yeah,
because I'm pretty sure that if you had a little bit more view, a little bit more range, you know, view area, you'd be able to survive a little bit longer. I'd say. Kind of want this.
Probably. The game had incredibly detailed sprites too, so.
Yeah. That's
sort of
right.
Double win of large sprites and a small screen. Yeah, it's still an amazing game. I love it. You know, if you're gonna play the series, I would say start with the first one, you know, and just go in chronological order, release order. So they're all great.
Oh, what? Oh, come on, I fell down too much. This is not easy. I mean, it's a bit confusing. Let's see if I can get through. Wiggle that booty. Wiggle that booty.
Shake that caboose. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. The butt wiggle of determination.
Yeah. Ready to pounce. Ready to go. Okay, cool. I reached something. Hey, come back. No. Okay. So the ladies are locked in. I see.
But for what purpose?
We will find out in the next episode. No, right now, actually.
Shantae Ballsy.
Shantae Ballsy. The return of Riskies. Okay, let me try to understand how this works, actually. Oh, okay, I don't have to hold the button. That's cool. Okay, good. Easy. Really easy.
Seek and is going to explode in 5 minutes, and Super Shantae is fighting Risky. It's not actually 5 minutes. It's like five fucking episodes.
Oh, that's awesome. Look at that. That's how they make mermaids. Counterfeit mermaids.
Yeah.
And that's how mermaids are made, folks. Folks.
What kind of monster could be doing this?
What kind of monster? You know that already, but I don't.
Indeed.
I'd say I don't think this is ammo baron stuff, actually.
Nah.
Might as well be risky.
Yeah.
Ow! Yeah, I forgot about jumping. Doom.
Ammo Baron wouldn't have an interest in any of it.
Ammo Baron
but
is weird.
There's a guy that does.
Hmm.
I'll be right back.
I think I missed something. Alright. I think I missed something.
Right now? No, you didn't.
Now, I didn't.
Like, what
that's
you want
cool.
to do right now is just ride the hooks all the way up. So,
all right, that's cool. I was
You're
talking about
right
this track. Section here. Yeah, I could have jumped through here maybe, but
you
that's...
You know what you can do though, when you get to the as high as you can go. Go all the way to the left and climb up the wall with the monkey. And you can actually get the bat transformation right now.
Oh.
Yeah. Luigi,
okay.
What's the word? We're playing Shantae.
Luigi rocks! Dude, he came. It's awesome.
He did. But yeah, try to get to the highest you can go on the left. And then when you reach that point, just start climbing.
All right. I'm against the right, actually, trying to unlock those bonuses. Trying to be as quick as possible about them, because collecting stuff on stream is not really usually the most attracting thing to do. So, transform!
I love that. It, man. It's Shantae, so, you know, of
yeah,
course
yeah,
I
yeah,
love
of
it.
Course, of course, of course. But it's a, you know, slow process.
How's it going, Luigi? How are we feeling this? He is in the second area. I don't want to say like dungeon or anything.
It's the second level, right?
You need to pass that
could
platform.
Be called level.
Yeah.
Sorry? Over there?
Yeah, you need to go to the right again, but when you come back to the left, I think you should be able to do it.
All right, so I'm gonna do this like So, oh, yeah, cool. I can drop down platforms. I want to test that. Usually in games, if you jump and press down, if you hold down and jump, that's it. You fall through platforms. Most of the games do that, and a lot of people forget about that feature.
Oh, yeah.
Can you actually kill those guys without being, like, detected or something?
Those guys?
Yeah.
Not really. You know, if you hit them, they know.
Because I saw, really... like, and there's an achievement about that.
Oh, well, it's,
okay, really over here, right?
Yeah, use the monkey now. Turn into a monkey.
Cool. Here you go.
Climb the fuck up there. Use the bullet to go across.
Hello!
Yeah, that was Bolo Avery.
Oh, cool! The bat dance. Awesome.
Yeah.
Alright, cool.
But that's you.
Oh, it can't go up and down. It's just horizontal. I see. Yeah, okay, that's cool. That's cool.
It doesn't sound like much, but it comes in handy sometimes, big time.
Well, that's the first form of flying so far. Yeah. You can't say it's not useful. Right?
It's pretty useful. Even after you get the harpy dance, you still use the bat for stuff. I would say it definitely has its purpose.
It looks like it's a precision flying kind of movement, which is something that if you just said that the harpy is back, it means that the flying might be kind of like awkward. If I remember that flying,
totally. Yeah, the harpy is very sloppy by comparison. You have a lot more freedom, but it's not the same experience for sure.
What's there? I see something. Wait.
Right there, you can't really do anything in there yet.
So it's a waste of time. Okay. All
right.
Cool.
Going in there right now is a waste of time. Yeah. You're pretty much done here. You.
Yeah. I asked that stuff because I don't want to get spoiled with the experience, but it actually helps with the stream purposes because it allows me to show more in less time.
That's cool.
Oh, wow, hi. Hello? A customer, you rang?
That's Tuki. Tuki will sell you some, including some dances that you can only get from her. She's got
warp
some
dance.
The warp dance is,
Dance to a warp to, dance to warp to a previously cleared areas within given worlds. Okay. The revive dance. I actually have money for not obliterate. Dryad dance. Okay. Blobfish dance.
Dryad's like a tree monster. Basically, you can't really do anything at all except she spawns the oranges.
Okay. Which, that's cool. Oranges are like healing items, right?
Yeah, totally, but they're the weakest ones. The gem jug is great, but it really only comes in handy, like, way later in the game.
And trade warp dance for gem jug. I don't have the warp dance, so yeah.
Yeah, don't even worry about it right now. You want the warp dance.
Revive?
Right now.
Warp dance. Yeah, okay. Either one of the two. Achievement!
Yeah, you don't really need to obliterate. I
can't buy anything else, I don't think.
Yeah, you're good now.
I can buy mega potions. That's always useful to have. Let me get 3 mega potions. I think that's the best move. I'm gonna get 3 mega potions, that's it. Let's move on. Oh, wow. Okay, that was fast.
The thing about
Triad Blobfish?
Yeah, a dry and a blobfish, they're both pretty much useless. That's the thing about Tuki's transformations, that the gem jug comes in handy later. And the dryad you can make a case for, but the blobfish literally just jumps around, and that's it.
I got the orange!
Oh yeah.
Oh boy. I can hit the guy actually. Yeah. Cool, cool. Let's go, let's go. Mm-hmm. Oranges and coconut shells. Remember the oranges? They explode.
Yeah.
Not in this game though.
Not in this game. We're safe from exploding oranges this time.
Dang it. Ah. This music is awesome.
It is great.
Oh, goodness.
It plays at another point later in the game, and it's even more epic later. For sure.
This level is not as hard as I thought it'd be. It's really easy to control, and...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I saw people having a lot of trouble in the demo, but...
Oh,
nope.
It's not hard. You know, this thing, like, it's not the first time you do something like this.
Yes! Achievement!
The one that you do later on in the game is a lot harder, but...
Okay.
It's still not that big of a deal.
Ouch. Oh, hi. Bolo, quit messing around.
Fucking...
Those were the missing maidens. Oh, okay. All right. But, That's what I said. Counterfeit mermaids.
Yeah.
I was right.
We'll do this.
Con man or woman.
Yeah.
I don't know if there is any real evil women besides Risky. Right? Now that I think about it.
Well, you know, if you don't want to count Nega Shantae, she's really just you know, a manifestation of pure evil.
Oh, goodness, you know my antivirus decided to appear. Hello, wild antivirus. Not a good time, boy.
I can think of another
Sorry?
Evil woman. So I can think of another evil woman, but I won't talk about it.
Oh, yes. I think I know what you're talking about. Oh, Techno Baron! I forgot about this guy. I completely forgot about this guy. Didn't he actually make an appearance, like the first time he appeared was in Pirate's Curse, right?
Yeah, it was. He was
talked about that guy. Oh, really?
The first actually appeared was Pirate's Curse. Or, yeah, Pirate's Curse.
Okay. Techno Baron. Lost count again. Who disrupts my concentration? I did. I saw your counterfeit mermaid factory and the fake mermaids. And now I'm sending you up the river just like your giant cans? Oh,
giant
yeah. Also kicking in. That's been nice.
You got a pretty bitchin' helmet, man. That thing is rad.
It looks like it can fire like anything at any moment.
It does.
How'd you get past my techno grunts?
I've never really used it for anything.
Pretty good chat right now. It's awesome.
Barons go.
Okay, I'll never leave this place. Oh, you'll okay. Oh, sleeping with the fishes. Okay. All right. Cool. Oh, what the? Ah, I remember you. Oh, goodness.
Yeah.
Holy mackerel.
That's, yeah.
yeah. Okay.
That's a captured big.
That's one big. Oh, yeah, definitely. I like my fish, but goodness.
The key here is destroying those locks. Don't even worry about what the hell she's doing. She'll be firing some shit at you. Just focus on those locks.
I'll go for it. Oh boy, I fell down. Dang it. Okay, Oh, it doesn't work. I mean, I'm gonna put the bubble just in case to avoid taking damage. I think that's the best option. I should try to reach the platform. Yeah, better.
Might as well.
Oh, the lasers. Oh, the lasers. Okay, let's try from the bottom first. Oh boy, I fell down.
Mm-mm.
What are you trying to do? Yeah, protection for days, boys! Oh boy. She's kind of in the background, so I don't suppose you can hit her in any way.
What's that?
Yeah, I remember Plush Minister. Welcome to the stream.
I don't. Sorry, man.
Yeah, it's timing, like off timing. Usually he leaves and you come by. It's a little bit of bad timing.
Okay. You're safe now. She's fucking pissed.
You're safe. Oh, leave me alone. She looks mad. She does look mad. Oh boy. Oh boy. That's bad. Eek! Oh, oops! I couldn't hit her more than once! Oh, come on. You gotta be kidding me.
You can really only hit her once. That's the thing. But she only takes, like, a couple more hits, so...
Okay, it's a quick kill then.
Yeah, that's what you're supposed to do.
Okay, cool. Nice. Good to know. Good to know I didn't, like... mess up anything.
Yeah, it looks like you're barely hurting her, but you're fine.
I'm pretty sure that you can, like, if you're quick enough, you can kind of climb back up and hit her twice.
Yeah, you can do that.
That must be a thing. Oh boy, I got hit.
If you have the harpy, it's pretty sweet because you can just sit there and like fire the harpy talent at her, and she's like dead in like a second. I mean, it's pretty cool.
Oh yeah. We'll have to be like way up against her, right? Like Harpy Talon.
Yeah. No, you can get like, you know, maybe where that that ring is right there.
Wait, but the Harpy Talon is not like scratching your enemy or something?
No, it's a projectile.
Oh, it changed to projectile. Okay. You're finished! Two hits in the last one. I knew you can climb back up. No, I'm going to finish Crash Twin Sanity, of course, but I wanted to play this one today. First, because I really wanted to try it out since 999 was over, so I switched them around a little bit. And I'm not playing Shantae Half-Genie Hero. And at the same time, that was a good day for Juan to co-commentate. So there you go. Yeah. I hope you Crash Twin Sanity fans are not sad about it. But there you go. I'm actually really happy about that. Techno Baron, you sick fiend. Ken,
sorry, Crash fans. I'm a busy man.
It's cool. It's all cool. I think the people understand. After all, it's a new game. I never played any Shantae game, and I was kind of hyped up for it. So, I think people understand that.
Sure.
So far so good. What else was I supposed to do when they're lying on a table? I ran out of legit mermaids after my orders were filled. Okay, so you counterfeit mermaids. No, Techno Baron. That's not good business. I'll give you the business. Hey, take that. Right in the face. Now she looks nicer.
It is murder. Avery. It is, in fact, murder.
What a freaky butt wipe. Okay. I guess I owe you all an apology. Uh-huh.
Indeed. Really, so now they won't appear in the level anymore. Now you got nothing.
Oh, no more mermaids. That's sad. Why the freaking Nagas have to appear? Why? Why?
Mermaids, come back, please.
Yeah, you're cool. I like your projectiles better than freaking, like, Nagas.
Well, these Nagas are a lot more, bearable than the Shantae.
Yeah. You referenced that before, which I think it's cool because Bolo, you suck. Bye. All clear. Second boss cleared. All right, that was a good run so far.
Boom.
I guess what I'm gonna do is probably run some errands right now, like collect a few things before ending the stream, and try to unlock the next level. And we'll call it an end. I think we are able to do that until midnight, I think, for me, like half an hour, maybe something like that, right? Seems fair?
Oh, wait. Absolutely. Sorry.
awesome. Look, crap transformation!
Oh, totally.
Oh, look at that speed! That's awesome.
This thing's like your best friend for a little while. You get the mermaid later on, but until then, like, you cannot do. There's so much to do in the water, you know? And this is what you're going to use most of the time.
For this point on, yeah.
Yeah.
So, as far as I know, there is a part in Burning Town, like the main street, that has water. I'm going to try to explore those sections with the crab for now. That's my objective right now. But first, story mode. So, I'm glad to hear you were able to set things right. Yep, all the mermaids, all the maidens, sorry, were returned home safe and sound. Every last mermaid too. I don't forget about them. So, how's your dynamo coming along, Hunkle? Well, the basics are all there, but according to my blueprint, I'm still missing four components, starting with the copper wiring. Okay, copper wiring. Wiring. I can fashion my own wire, but I'd like a piece of copper ore. Okay, cool. No problem. I'll find something for you. Atta girl.
Do yourself a favor. Go to Sky's hatchery and talk to the little girl in there with her.
There's a little girl there? Wait a second.
Yeah. There is now.
Flip a copper coin into the air.
We're going to get some copper ore. That's what we're going to do now.
All right. Gosh. I thought this was a candy store, but all I see is... are these? But all of these eggs have dumb birds inside. My goodness! Ah! You can get this game on Steam, and you can also get this game on, I think, Wii U, PS4, and Xbox One? Question mark?
Vita. It's not on Xbox One yet.
It's not on Xbox One yet, but it's going to be, right?
It's going to be. Just
at least it's planned for it. And on the Switch, actually. It's also planned for the Switch.
It's planned for the Switch as well. So anybody who is getting a Switch and wants to play this, you can. I don't know when.
But yeah, that was to answer my sister. Actually, this game I'm now playing, this game is the Steam version. You can play it on your computer too. So if you have a Steam account, you can get it.
What's up, Marina? How's it going?
Is that for me? Help yourself. Salted caramel. Oh, thank you. In return, I'd like to give you 1 year of pay. Bird seeds. I feel so proud.
She gets paid in birds.
Lame, I know. Okay, yeah, that's cool. You bird. That's why you're in a hatchery right now.
So go ahead and take that bird seed over to the item shop.
Okay. No, sir. See that? I crave protein. Only the eggs of a monster will slake my thirst. All right, I'll give you that. Bathhouse. I don't think I need that. No, that's good.
Once you go back to Mermaid Falls, the Nagas drop those eggs all the time. So it's.
Oh, hello, Mister.
Easiest way.
Does this place sell remedies for birds? My pet, Mr. McBicklin. McBicklin. Here has an upset stomach. If only I had some seeds. Yeah. I have some seeds for you. Bye, Dan. Thanks for watching.
I wonder what could be in the bird's stomach.
I wonder. Could wait, maybe what? Be some copper ore? That'd be hilarious, actually.
Later, Ocean Prince. See you later, man.
Wait, no. Yes! What's jamming with this egg? Here, hold this. Oh my goodness, it actually is copper ore.
Yeah.
Yeah, the bird actually pooped copper ore.
Yeah.
I mean, what the heck?
Mr. Oh, this.
You're a copper machine. No, not really. You eat copper. You shouldn't. The heck is wrong with you? Those birds. Birds these days.
Birds these days.
All right. I don't know why I'm... Yeah, birds these days. They eat pretty much anything. Hello, Mimic. Here's the copper ore. Yeah, it's for you. Take that. Oh, it's quite easy. Yeah, it's quite easy. So make my copper wire. According to the blueprint, it goes right there. Phew.
Who made that fast?
Eh? Thank you. Okay, no problem, Uncle. Uncle, remind me again, who's Uncle? Oh my gosh.
He has the case of olds.
Okay, but never like this, yeah, Uncle. What's wrong with him, Bolo? Who's Bolo? Oh my goodness. Oh no, not you too.
Yeah. Some foul shit is afoot.
Maybe a walk in the brain. That should fix it. No, that doesn't. Okay, I'm gonna see if I can find help. Oh boy. Well,
sounds like some kind of porous bread bowl.
Okay, let's see. Shop. I actually kind of want to see if I can buy anything, but I don't think so. Boy, oh boy. Okay, not now. Then I can upgrade. Hello, Mayor. Scuttlebutt.
Yeah.
The streets! What is your
yeah,
new
where
Gordon
is that
genie?
Where?
Where is her? Where is she? Where is... What she's doing? What? Somewhere? Ugh. But
this
we need
like
her help.
Bitch, man.
Hey, you can hire me again. I won't be mad. You didn't have no idea where she went? I can't remember. Oh. Okay, give me Tasseltown map. Okay, cool. So we unlock the next.
Yeah, you know, it seems like it would be Hypno-Baron's deal, but it's a little different than that, actually. It's,
Oh, right, Hypno-Baron, yeah, that's right. But no, yeah, of course. All right.
So Holly is in Tasseltown to investigate this shit. So let's go find Holly and see if she's found anything.
We need to go to the next level then, right? So before we do that, I'm going to hold off for the next stream. And instead of that, hi. You look kind of bad. Sky, who am I? Sky, snap out of it.
He's all zoned out and shit.
I need you to take me to Tasseltown. Tasseltown? Nah, never mind. Yeah. Just ask me to climb up. Yes. Just ask me to climb aboard. Okay, climbing aboard. Let's go. Rank. No, I should ride that. I should ride the bird. Okay.
Wonder if Holly will ever be DLC. You know, I don't think so. There's already going to be, you know, Risky Bolo Sky and Roddy, which is a lot. Holly would be kind of cool, though. I think she would have some pretty interesting abilities. as you'll see later on. But I doubt she'll ever be played. It would be cool.
As you can see, we unlocked Tasseltown, but I'm back here because, like I said earlier, I want to explore those levels and get as many stuff as I can, as much stuff as I can from them as soon as possible. So I'm going to explore underwater without our newly acquired power-up of the cutesy little, crab.
Crab, yeah. There are two things you can get in the water right now. There's a third pipe that you'll see, but you can't go into it yet.
I should transform before going in the water because I don't know why Shantae cannot dance in the water, which kind of makes sense. I guess. Right. Okay, let's move on.
I don't fault her for not being able to dance in the water. She can do a lot of other cool stuff.
Definitely. And I hope to see most of those soon. Can you actually get the upgrade for... each animal has its own upgrades. Like, you have the monkey bullet. Each of the transformations has a power-up, right? When are you to get the crab power-up? Soon or still a ways later?
It's a little bit later on.
Okay. So I don't need to bother with that. Probably won't get it this stream. Ouch!
No,
ouch! Oh
no,
boy!
Not right now.
There's a second.
It's something that you really need to have around the fourth chapter. So right now, like after Tasseltown. So
Greenstone.
Right now,
Oh, cool. Converts green gems to magic. That's going to be useful.
Yeah, totally.
Excuse me.
Does
movement help with those?
The crab's upgrade comes in handy big time. As far as
collecting. I can see that. Yeah, I can see that. It's like your first step into water sections, which hold a lot of secrets apparently.
Totally.
So there you go. We're in a new area. That's the pipe you're talking about. I can't reach it. Yeah, of course. So that's the mermaid pipe, right?
Okay. Yeah. That's later on.
Cool.
That's really late in the game. That you're even gonna go there. It's.
And get the mermaid. Yeah.
You'll know it when it comes up, but it's. Don't even think about that right now.
Okay, I suppose there's nothing else to get.
Not right now.
Oh, there's a water section here. Wait a second. Don't go there. It's a trap. Okay, maybe. Oh boy. Yeah, it kind of like looks like a trap. It's awesome. Oh, come on, let me jump. Oh, come on. Just die, thank you. Officially, I don't like those. Starfish.
I don't think you plan on avoiding the crab upgrade.
Sorry? Crab upgrade is required to beat the game?
Game can't be avoided. I don't think you were planning.
Oh, no. No. We won't skip anything. Actually, I want to do 100% if I can. That's why I'm coming back to those levels. I'm trying to get as much stuff as possible. And see if I can aim for 100%. And maybe later do a little speedrun myself to see, but I'm pretty sure I won't be able to beat the master of Shantae. There's no water sections here, right?
There aren't any, no. You're good.
Okay, let's move on then. We don't have anything else to do then. Maybe later with the RP form or something, but I'm not sure. So, let's go.
Oh, okay, that's what you're talking about. All right. No, that's yeah, he's not gonna miss it. Definitely.
Oh yeah, yeah, okay, yeah. Yeah, I'm not gonna miss it. That's cool. That's cool to know because
there's nothing like
that. Okay, we're back.
You know, you'll miss.
Yeah, yeah. We're back here at Mermaid Falls and Sunken Soul. I got a Sunken Soul, which I will probably guess that's going to be handy later.
Yeah.
And here we go. Now it goes. Monster Egg. That's cool. Okay, we needed that. Yeah. I remember that that person needed protein from Monster Eggs. So these enemies healed Monster Eggs. That's cool. Good to know. Good to know. Oh, I didn't notice that you can actually use a shield with the crab form. That's cool. Awesome. This is blocked, right? Yeah, this is blocked.
Yeah, you can't go there.
Cool. You can't go there, boy.
The crab is pretty limited as far as what she can do. But for this point in the game, it's still pretty fun to have.
Oh, it's a good form to have. I'm exploring a lot more area than I thought. And it's not really that hard to use, except for the slow diving, you know. And even then, yeah. I don't think you can do anything here at all. Wow. Okay. Computer Face, hello. What a nice name. It's Krabby.
Indeed.
It's Krabby. Yeah.
Yeah, Monster Eggs are good healing items. The gator steaks are better, for sure.
Another Monster Egg. I'm gonna just roam around the water. Oh boy, I think I just screwed it all up. Okay, I see. Okay, back to. I should have calculated that would happen, but I'm collecting stuff, so it's not bad. Like gems, I mean, for the upgrade. Now, right now, I have enough gems to upgrade the hair one bit, which will be awesome and useful really soon. But I know there's a section underwater really near. Let's see. Okay, and can I do this actually? Can I actually reach the other side of that part, that wall somehow? Over there?
No.
Okay, no, not with the crab form at least.
Yeah.
Okay, what next? What am I missing?
Right now, you're pretty much, there's not really a lot, actually. You know, you could go to the second area, and there's some stuff you can get in the water. But honestly, there's a part later on when you get the crab upgrade, which is...
Okay.
Where you have
okay, I see.
Grass basically, and you're going to get that stuff anyway, so it's like you really don't need to turn it into two trips, but if you want to get it right now, you can. But
okay, I'm going to then leave this for the next stream maybe. We'll see when we get there. But yeah. Definitely.
Rockin'.
So let's call the birdie Wrench, our friend.
Yeah.
Since the very first game, he actually became useful for fixing a machine in Risky's Revenge, if you remember, the coffee machine.
Yeah, man. Wrench fucking rules, man. He opened Dribble Fountain in the first game. Remember?
That's true.
It wasn't Dribble Fountain, it was
It wasn't Dribble Fountain, it was the other one.
It was the other place.
What's it called? It's the desert one. It's the one you get the elephant form. So, I don't think we have anything else to do, to be fair. Am I correct?
Right now, really don't.
Besides going to
Tasseltown. Once you finish Tasseltown, you'll have a lot of stuff to do. But right now,
all right.
That's your goal. So.
And to be honest, I think it's a good stopping point. We'll get the cliffhanger of going to Tasseltown. What is that mysterious half-genie doing?
Indeed.
And why isn't she taking care of Skulltown like she's supposed to? Right?
Yeah.
Let me just get
supposedly they're investigating, but we don't really know what Tasseltown is or why she would go there in particular to investigate this. I mean, there's a lot of shit up in the air. And that bitch is a trifling bitch. So.
Oh, my backdash. I needed the backdash for some reason. I kind of miss it. I use it a lot in the other games. Yeah, it's one of the moves I use a lot to avoid attacks quickly. Yeah, that's a must-have. And now,
I never really,
really fast whipping.
It
really fast whipping
cool,
power.
But I never really use it.
I use it much more than a lot of people do, actually. I noticed that. Awesome. Great. Look at that speed. Look at that hair speed. I mean, you couldn't do that with your neck. It's impossible.
No. Shantae has a very impressive spine. For sure.
Yeah, definitely.
Taking a lot of abuse.
It's magical. It's magical.
She's really
built
those muscles up. She's got a swole neck.
Definitely. So, okay, I think it's time for us to take a break from Shantae for today. And I think it was a good 2-hour stream almost. We'll try to separate them a little lighter now so everybody can enjoy them and it's not too long for people to, you know, to watch. And next time we're going to check out Tasseltown and see what that genie is doing. Meanwhile, I'm going to turn on the end stream chat time with my viewers and today with Juan to for you to ask the questions you want. So I'll be here in just a second after the little intro plays out. Here we go. Here we are.
Yeah, Mario. Oh boy. Shantae's been doing this for a while. she's pretty good at what she does. And rightfully so. If you really think about it, like, I mean, all the magic stuff aside, Shantae is, like, super athletic and, like super. She's always running and jumping, and she could be, like, an Olympic athlete. She's like, I don't know. It's just, you don't really think about it, but it is. Pirate's Curse, she's got no powers that whole game. She's just a normal girl. And she's doing all that shit.
And she does it. Yeah. She does it all.
Yeah, totally. So it's
honestly the only thing that Pirate's Curse took away from Shantae was the ability to transform.
Yeah.
That's all, I think. Let me just lower the volume of the music, sorry.
As far as, like, things that really make a difference, yeah. For sure. And the pirate gear.
Alright, guys, did you like the game so far? What do you think about the game? Are you hyped for it? Are you hyped to see more of it? I surely did enjoy everything I saw so far. I don't know about you guys. I really want to keep playing, guys, honestly. But I'm going to have to stop for today, maybe. Make it a little shorter. And like I said, it's going to be really, really... it's going to be a lot better for people to watch this stream back. And I really want people to check out the stream and not be afraid. I don't want them to be afraid by 6 hours of stream, you know? What happened with 999.
999 was a
that was
hell of a marathon,
7 actually
for sure. Oh, well, I don't think anybody saw that coming. I mean, we kind of all thought it would be the same length as the other endings, and turns out to be this huge thing. But
yeah, definitely.
It was satisfying. It was definitely satisfying.
And I saw a lot of people left a like on the live stream. Thank you very much. The 12 likes we got today were awesome. And everybody who came here today was awesome too. And I'm really sorry if I didn't read the whole chat today. But of course, with the guest commentators, you know how it works. So yeah, thank you once again, everybody, for coming. And if you have any questions, let us know. If you have anything to ask right now, let us know. We're 100% now with the chat. Any questions you want to ask about the game, about Juan, about myself, about anything, about the channel, you're free to go. You go ahead, shoot your questions, and we'll be here to answer.
Indeed.
Is there any plans of a consistent stream schedule in the future, or is it just whenever you're available? Right now, it's whenever I'm available. I won't be able to create a schedule. I tried several times, but I failed. This is one of my Patreon goals. Reaching a certain goal on Patreon as monthly donors, I will be able to create a schedule and make this an actual job, you know? So that will include putting the schedules as I want and planning days ahead. I'll probably even plan streams like a month ahead, so you know exactly when those streams will happen. It will come all together if the channel is supported well enough. But sadly, right now I can't do better than this. I'm kind of restrained by other schedules.
Indeed. I would say you do your best to give notice, though, far enough away so that people could, you know to tune in to watch it.
Yeah. I should have kind of I'm never certain that I'm gonna stream. I have a plan. Like, probably I'm gonna stream tomorrow, but who knows if I'm gonna stream tomorrow? You know, everything could happen, and I'm at last second, I might not be able to stream, and it happens. Now, one thing is for sure. I think I'm going to be able to stream. Today is Wednesday, technically. It's Wednesday for me, actually. Right. Am I crazy?
Yeah,
it's Wednesday. Yeah, so I'm going to be streaming Friday, and probably at the same time. I'm going to start to do the streams at this time. I think it's a little bit better. I'm going to try to end them sooner so people don't get too tired. And we'll see. And that, next time will be Crash Bandicoot, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. But that's the best I can say.
I missed the last Crash stream, actually, so I don't even know what's going on in that game.
Craziness and a lot of fury of my part.
I'm sure craziness. I could definitely predict a little bit of that for sure, but it's, I want to see it. I don't know why I missed it. I think I was working.
Yeah. That's a huge problem. I'm having with the streams too, is finding the right timing to record. I thought about putting them later, like 1 a.m., but then a lot of people from my time zone won't be able to watch the videos, and it's going to be harder for me to record. But if I do it sooner, other people won't be able to watch the stream. So it's really, really hard for me to come up with a good time to record those streams. So what I'm going to probably do is I'm going to probably make a poll on Twitter and ask your opinions on Discord to know exactly what you guys want what would be the perfect time for you to watch a stream and how long do you want the stream to be.
That might be a good idea. But, you know, at the end, no matter what, there's always going to be somebody who... It's just the way it works, you know? Unfortunately.
My sister actually asked a question. For someone who has never played Shantae, there's a hard, you know, curve, you know, learning curve. But you quickly get it. So what I'm trying to say is... play it for a little bit, and you'll get used to the controls. They're not that hard. The more abilities you get, the harder the controls are. But this game here has really good controls so far. So trust me, it's really easy to understand. So I'd say it's not a problem to get started with Shantae. And this game is a good one to start with. If you want a balanced challenge. So far, that's what I saw. It's a good one. And yeah, if Juan can back me up on this one, right?
Of course. If you can play Mario, you can play. You'll see this is just don't start with the Game Boy Color version. I completely disagree. I started with the Game Boy Color version. A lot of people started with the Game Boy Color.
I believe too that the Game Boy Color version, since it's the first game, you should try to start with that one. However, if you're not too familiarized with gaming, and if you're not really a hardcore gamer, you might see a great challenge at the beginning of the game. Don't feel down, pulled down by that, because you can actually, the game actually gets better and better as you go on. And if you like exploration, the first game is perfect for you.
Oh yeah, it's more of a seamless sort of open world, which is as opposed to like this game, which is broken up with, you know, you've got Main Street over here and you know, Tasseltown over here and all that stuff. Mm-hmm. The thing with the first one is that you start off in this big world with very little health and not a lot of abilities, and you'll run into some pretty tough enemies. So it's just sort of dealing with that and learning how that goes. Other than that, you know, there's this reputation of it being this hard game. It's not. You know, I was a kid when I played it. It was fine. So of course, I'm going to recommend playing the first one first. I think chronological order is the way to go. You know, the games do have a connected story. It's very loose, but if to get the maximum experience,
it's the kind of game that you don't need to play the previous one to understand the story, but at the same time, if you want to get the full lore of the game, the series, you have to play them all.
Exactly.
I want to really quickly address something that Leonard Clements told me. I believe that information that says, Jack, just so you know, the payment of mine is a little behind due to the first being today and not tomorrow. Leonard. For those who don't know, Leonard Clements is one of the patrons that support the channel. But sadly, I don't know what happened, but it said cancelled for this month. So I don't know what happened there. You should definitely check that out. I know it's not a problem, but just to make sure that if you cancel it, that's good to know the reason why. Maybe it's okay. It's completely understandable. Back to the topic at hand, though. Collectathons. Collectathons. Shantae is one of the good examples of that. Now, we're not talking about the kind of collectathon that is DK64. If you actually didn't like the amount of the complex collection of DK64, that's not it. That's not the type of collectathon. It's more of a Metroidvania type game. So if you liked Metroid, you'll like this kind of game. It's in a sense that of its structure and level design. It's not as much. It's different from Metroid, of course, but at the same time, the basis is the same. The inspiration for the style of game is the same.
It's often compared to Wario Land, actually. If you like Wario Land, it's pretty similar, especially the first game. It's very similar to Wario Land 3.
In style, too. Not only in gameplay, but also in style.
Oh, exactly. Yeah, they in fact, that's how I got into the series to begin with. I was a huge fan of Wario Land when I was a kid. I still am. But, you know, Wario Land was my favorite game. And I had just finished Wario Land 3. This was before Wario Land 4 had come out. And I saw the ads and shit for Shantae and Nintendo Power. And, you know, I look at it. It looks like Wario Land with a cute genie girl. So I got
it. Yeah, it's awesome. It's awesome.
And yeah, it basically is that. You know, when I describe the the series to people and they ask, what's it like? I say, it's Wario Land with a cute genie girl. So
more specifically, Wario Land 3, definitely. So if you liked Wario Land 3, just go for Shantae GBC, no problem. If you like Metroid and Wario Land 3, just go for it. Just go for it, you'll like it.
Totally. And, you know, I love Wario Land 3, so...
And of course, like I said before, don't be demotivated by the first game, because even if you finish the first game and you weren't satisfied, the future games get better and better, and they strengthen the formula even more, and the charm is still there. It didn't change much. The game is still the same. It feels the same, but it's improved. Each title that comes out has an improved controls, improved levels, and for what I saw for this game, this is just brilliant so far. So trust me, it gets better.
Oh, it's like I said, it's the sum of its parts. You know, it's you can clearly see through the evolution of the series, like the lessons that they learn as they go, as far as developing these games, as far as like, you know, what works, what doesn't work, what could be better.
Yeah, definitely.
Sort of. So
definitely.
Half-Genie Hero, in that regard, is a extremely polished game. Like, the transformations are just smooth as butter. It's on the fly, you know. It's the level structure is perfect. It's really something. It's the new standard for Shantae games. It's something, really.
It's definitely something. And Leonard Clements said, what about Sonic? I should say that my sister and I didn't grow up on Sonic games, actually. We never actually played a Sonic game as a kid. We grew up with Nintendo and Crash Bandicoot. So,
I heard that you really weren't much of a Sonic guy.
I never really went into like Sonic craze or anything. The only game of Sonic that I actually played and enjoyed was Sonic Generations. Aside from that, I can't say I didn't enjoy the other ones, but yeah.
It's a pretty good one. I don't know. It's not a bad one to say is your first one.
The Generations is awesome. Generations is awesome.
Yeah, no, it's a fine one. I'm going to go take a piss. I'll be right back.
Wow. All right. Correction. Anything with Shantae is perfect to Juan, definitely. Even Runbo has a DLC for Shantae as a character. So if you want more Shantae and you like Runbo, there's a DLC that you can play as Shantae and Runbo. So,
and
yeah.
It's awesome, by the way. I bought Runbo just to play that, and it's cool.
There you go. A game for you guys to check out. Runbo. I can type it in the chat. If you don't know the game, I can type it. Runbo. So... pun. It's a play on words with running and rainbow. Not a crazy Sonic fan, though. Yeah. Yeah. There you go. Sonic. Sonic is one of those games that you either grew up with Sonic and you like Sonic, or you either grew up with Mario and you like Mario. So it's like, yeah. What about the Shantae version of Power Ranger? Power Rangers with Shantae would be kind of interesting. The transformations and stuff. It's cool. Did you see how charming this game is? Did you see how much humor and little details there are in this game? We just started the game. Apparently it's short, but at the same time, it's... let me tell you. It's really charming. Are you considering following up the Shantae series with a playthrough of Mighty Switch Force 1 and 2? I don't own those games, but I can try. I can try to get my hands on those games at some point. Although, of course, I am going to play the other Shantae games in the future, I hope. So, Mighty Switch Force might be an idea for me to play after Shantae is finished, or in between, you know. I can try that, no problem. I'll see
fun.
If I can get my hands on the game. I mean, at the time I'll start playing it, it's going to be a classic.
Oh, totally, man. I'm not a, you know, giant Mighty Switch Force fan. You know, certainly not like I am with Shantae, but you know, I like it. And I'll definitely hang out for that one.
I saw some speedruns of Mighty Switch Force, which are quite impressive, to be honest. You have to really have the control over the switching mechanic, which that's the whole premises of the game. It's like you have those levels with a lot of red and blue blocks. You have to switch around there if they're transparent or solid. And it's really interesting how the speedrunners know exactly which button to press and when to make everything happen exactly how you need to. It's incredible. It's really cool to see a speedrun of that game.
I'm going to have to go watch my Switch Force speedruns after this.
Oh, definitely. GDQ actually is a good place to check out a few of them. And then from then on, you have a lot of YouTubers that might be into speedrunning and might have speedrun that game. So yeah, definitely go check those out.
It seems like it'd be fun.
I'm not a speedrunner myself. The only game I did a speedrun of, besides Shantae Pirate's Curse, was Metroid. And I usually try to do Metroid Fusion and Metroid Zero Mission, which are my two favorite Metroid games. Really different from one another, but at the same time, they play really similarly. And I really like the controls of the GBA versions. So yeah, I try to speedrun those games. But it's been a while since I actually actively speedrun a game. I used to also speedrun DKC, the DKC series, which was awesome too.
Nice. I pretty much only do Shantae. I did a really good run of Half-Genie Hero a couple days. I came within seconds of the 100% world record.
Bye, sis.
So, later. So I'm gearing up to try that again so I can take that title.
Who knows, someday I can try it myself to see if I can get that picture. That unlockable picture.
The bikini one? That's a great one. I love
that. That's great, Leonard. Thank you. Thank you,
Leonard. I'm going to get a tattoo for sure.
You're going to actually get a tattoo of that? Or are you just saying?
Yeah, totally. I already have the Shantae.
Oh, that's great. And you know what? It's actually part of your collection if you look at it.
Yeah, man, totally.
You if you guys are interested in seeing Juan's collection of Shantae stuff, go check out Discord, because if you join the server, we're all there. And you can share your own work if you're an artist, some kind of artist, you know, any kind of work you do, you can share that with people. And also, you're invited to go there and relax. And if you actually like to listen to music while you work on art or even work at school, you need some music to on demand and stuff, just go there, chill out, talk to people, know people, and maybe you'll find other artists and share thoughts with them. So that's the whole idea behind that chat. And not only that, you can keep in touch with me and everybody in the chat that has joined so far, including Juan and Luigi Rocks and Kyle. And there's a lot of people that come here on the streams every time that are there. So join in and have fun, okay? You're all welcome. You'll have to wait for me to give you approval. But if you're patient enough, you can read the rules meanwhile. You just wait a little bit and I'll give you the access, me or any members of the staff. Okay?
Oh, yeah. It's we're all pretty active on there, so someone will show up and you'll be fine. No,
yeah, definitely.
You'll never have to wait that long.
And it's more about chilling out. So even if no conversation is up, you can still join in, listen to music, and chillax, you know? Have a good time and even focus on your work there. That's the whole idea. And you can request songs because we have bots that work on your music, you know. So you can go there and just relax. Just take your time. And aside from that, I know a lot of you guys might be fans of Wario. So I would invite you to join the Wario forums because we're there too. I know it's not a good time for Wario stuff, but really soon I'm going to play Wario Land The Shake Dimension on the channel as a live stream, and I'm going to release a t-shirt for the occasion. So make sure you join the Wario forums and meet the people there. share your thoughts about the Warriorlands and the WarioWare series, because man, those games are awesome too. And since we were talking about that, we were comparing Shantae with Wario, why not, right?
Yeah, totally, man. If you like Shantae, you'll like WarioLand. WarioLand is a brilliant series, and that's, once again, that's how I found Shantae.
And so, vice versa, too.
Yeah,
if you like Shantae, you like Wario, but vice versa, like Wario, like Shantae, you know?
Totally.
They're kind of there. You kind of, you should be able to enjoy those games. So give them a try. If you like one of them, go for the other and try them and let us know.
Every single WarioLand game is awesome. There's no bad one at all.
And share your thoughts with us. You can also share your thoughts with us. We all always like to talk about different topics, so go ahead.
Conquer after WarioLand. I'm eager to see Conquer myself, dude.
And I still have to find a way to record Conquer. I'll get my hands on Conquer and record it like good emulation type or original game. Who knows at the time what will happen. I'll have to finish Crash to Insanity first, so let's wait for that to happen. I don't know how far I am from the game. I never played the game, so I can't tell you exactly how far I am in Crash to Insanity. But I really hope that everybody falls into place. Everything falls into place.
I think it will.
Yeah, me too.
Everything seems to be working out. Luigi would be a good guest for the Conquer stream too. I didn't even think about that. He's all about Conquer.
His picture is Conquer.
Yeah, he's big into Conquer. And for good reason. Conquer.
Yep, definitely.
I think we have a rare conversation at least every other day.
Yeah, if it's not about DK, it's about Banjo-Kazooie, and if it's not about either of the two, it's about Conquer. So there's always a topic about those games, and Rare is really good at those games. At the time, all Rare was awesome.
Oh man, yeah, I've said it before, I'll say it again. Rare during their golden era was comparable to Pixar during their golden era. It was just hit after hit after hit, and they were all masterpieces. It was insane. It was like they made a deal with the devil, like to just have this perfect game.
And, definitely.
Of course, it was not to last.
Sadly, Microsoft, right?
Yeah. When Behind the Music continues. Or Behind the development. I don't know.
Behind this, no.
Rare got hooked on heroin, and then their game began to suffer. I don't know.
And the band started to separate, one member at a time, dismantling. Dismantling the band forever.
Chris Seaver just shows up drunk, and Nick Stamper got locked up for manslaughter. You know, that sort of thing.
That's a good point. Was actually Rare starting to split off before they actually got bought out? That's a good point.
You know, I think it was very clear that the times were changing for them. Had they not been bought out, it would not have ended like it did. But eventually, maybe. I don't know. There's no real way to tell. But
to be fair, you know what happened with DK after Rare left, right? So, you know, like DK Donkey Konga. And stuff like that appeared. I think Nintendo didn't really know what to do with those games, so
yeah,
we got the bongos. And a lot of people liked the bongos, but at the same time, it wasn't really Donkey Kong, you know? For the GameCube, you don't really have a good Donkey Kong game compared to what we had before. It's not like those games were bad, but, you know, they lacked they lacked that essence, you know, the Donkey Kong essence. That was something. They changed Donkey Kong a lot.
Yeah. You know what was actually supposed to be like a lot better than I thought was Donkey Kong Jungle Beat. Apparently that was like halfway deep. I did not play it. I assumed it sucked, but it's not. A following.
Yeah, it's not the best thing ever, but at least it's a platformer with the essence of Donkey Kong a little bit.
Yeah.
It's playable, it's fun to play, but it's not really... Well, if you play on the GameCube, you have to play with the bongos, so there you go. If you don't like the bongos, you're stuck with it. But now there's the new Play Control version, which uses the Wiimote and the nunchuck to actually do the bongo effect, you know? So you can actually play... And the controls are a bit tweaked, so you can actually... I think you can move DK with the joystick instead of just mashing the bongos, which is a lot better, of course.
No kidding. It's, but yeah, there's no way it'll reach the heights of DK64, you know, or the DKC games. It's just...
Oh, yeah, definitely. Definitely. And what was interesting about that is that the bongos were actually really good as a hardware piece, as they would actually detect your clapping and the bongo hitting.
Yeah.
So it was quite interesting as a hardware piece.
They were a lot more well received and just a lot more, I don't know, it was very unexpected to see the usage of the bongos extend as much as it did. Like, they had a pretty healthy lifespan, and it was impressive. There were like three Donkey Konga games. Like,
oh yeah, one was only released in Japan. I think it was the third one. It was only released in Japan, but the other two came out outside Japan, and they had a good reception. Weirdly, that maybe they brought like outside gamers from outside, you know, new gamers to the console at some point, because they were kind of like party games.
Yeah, totally. It looks like... I've never played Donkey Konga, but it looks like a lot of fun.
Hey, you know a little known fact? Donkey Konga 3 had Mona Pizza as one of the songs.
I heard about that. That's pretty rad.
The Japanese version of Mona Pizza from WarioWare was actually one of the songs you could play on the bongos
That's
in Donkey Konga 3.
Cool, I would love to play awesome. Mona Pizza on bongos, dude.
Yeah.
That's just gotta be fun.
John, you're too late, but don't worry. This stream is actually really short compared to the other ones, so I think you'll have time to catch up, no problem, okay? And don't worry. Don't worry. The streams won't be too long. That's the reason why I also wanted to make them shorter, so people can catch up easily. Not 7 hours to catch up on. No, you have 2 hours max, more or less, let's say. And that's it. So this stream is probably right now around 2 hours and 20 minutes, something like that. So if you missed this stream, don't worry, you can catch up easily.
Yeah, it's all good.
It's all good.
You'll be fine, trust me.
All right. Well, I don't know. Anyone wants to ask anything else before we go? I think it's gonna be it's a good time for us to say goodbye. I think. What do you think, Juan?
I would say you're right. For sure, I think we're all genied out for the moment.
Yep. I think it was a good session, and I wish I could play more. Actually, I really wanted to play more today.
I was gonna say personally, I'm gonna go play Shantae myself, but
and you should do
as
too.
Far as
and
the stream.
yeah, definitely. So I think you should you guys in the chat, you guys watching today, go get a Shantae game and play along. If you want to get Shantae Half-Genie Hero right away, and follow the streams, go ahead, do that. It's a great game so far, and even you can also like help if you already played the game, right? If you haven't, well, there's your experience, and you can play it on any platform, like I said, except Xbox for now, but any platform, home console and computer, I don't think portable is one of them. I don't think there's any portable versions of Shantae Half-Genie Hero.
There's a Vita version.
Oh, the Vita version. Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Which basically means there's no portable version because, you know, it's fucking Vita. All right, Luigi, dude. I will see you later. Probably.
All right, guys. See you all later. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for your support. And I will see you next stream, probably Friday, I hope. Okay?
All right.
See you guys.
Good night and good luck.
Good night. Do that.